So in your seat, let it be supported. I'm going to sit on a pile of blankets. You can sit on a bolster. You can sit on a chair. You don't even have to sit on the ground. If sitting on the ground is uncomfortable or there's something going on in the knee or the ankle joint that really doesn't let you sit tall, just grab a chair and sit tall in your chair. You can just set your strap off to the side and just kind of feel your sit bones right and left settling into your seat. Relax your hands, relax your shoulders. Notice where your shoulders are in space. So oftentimes the body or the spine has some habitual patterns or behaviors that we become unconscious of over time. So just take a moment to feel your shoulders shift back over your hips, your ears even shift back over your shoulders so that you're stacking your spine nice and tall. Just take a few deep breaths in and out through the nose here. Just allow yourself to arrive into your practice, into this moment, onto your mat. Just noticing how your body feels. How does your energy level feel? What is your emotional state like? So I'd like to introduce you to, most of you probably know this, but maybe some of you don't, a pranayama practice called Nadi Shodhana. It means alternate nostril breathing. It's a really helpful pranayama practice for things like seasonal allergies and also to really tap into your parasympathetic nervous system. So it can be challenging if you do have a stuffed up nose. I recommend grabbing a Kleenex, blowing your nose, see if you can get your nasal passageway a little bit more open. And then when you feel like you can very gently feel the lips, breathe in and out through the nose. You might just try that a couple of times. You might notice without doing anything with your hands, one nostril might feel more open or easier to breathe out of than the other one. Just bring your awareness to your nose. Notice the right nostril, the left nostril. And then notice there's a relative, it's very subtle, but there's a relative difference between the temperature of your breath as you inhale and as you exhale. So our inhale breath tends to be slightly cooler. And our exhale breath tends to be slightly warmer. And see if you can tune into that really subtle shift of temperature. And so we'll start the practice of Nadi Shodhana. You can do this imagining you're breathing in through one side, exhaling through the other. You can do this without the hands. So you can imagine alternate nostril breathing. If using the hand causes anxiety, just relax your hand. If you're going to try it, take your index finger, middle finger of your right hand into the palm of the hand. And so then you have this little kind of claw with your pinky finger and your ring finger and your thumbs just sticking out to the side. You're going to take this and rest it against the crescents of the nose. Let your elbow draw in towards your body so it's relaxed. Let your shoulder relax. You can slightly tilt the chin towards the chest so that the back of the neck is nice and neutral. Deep breath in through both nostrils. Deep breath out. And start off by closing the right nostril, inhaling through the left. Closing left, exhaling right. Inhaling right. Close right, exhale left. So that's one round. We'll do four more. Keeping the right closed, inhale left. Close left, exhale right. Inhale Inhale right. Close right, exhale left. Up two rounds. See if you can do the last two on your own. Just follow the pathway of breathing. The completion of your inhale is at the apex of your forehead, right between the two eyes. The completion of your exhale is about 4 to 6 inches beyond the tip of the nose. It's like you're drawing a triangle in your mind's eye with your breath. Following the pathway of breathing. Next time you exhale out through the left nostril, let your right hand relax on top of your thigh. Maybe your eyes are closed, but if they're not, just try to close the eyes or rest the gaze at the very tip of the nose so that you're drawing the awareness inward. Notice how you feel. Has anything changed within the breathing? Any subtle shifts of awareness? Take two more deep, slow breaths in and out through the nose here. Good. Okay, so we'll start to settle into one of our first holds, and we'll incrementally work our way up to longer holds. So these first few rounds of holds will be just about a minute long. And we'll actually, if you're seated on a chair, I'll have you come down to the floor and take a really loose cross-legged seat like I'm sitting. And when I say loose, I mean don't worry about how close your heels are to your pelvis. Don't worry how close your knees are to the floor. Give yourself the support you need. So recommend continuing to elevate the sit bones on a prop. And if the knees are really far away from the floor, you can slide pillows or blankets or anything underneath the outer edges of the knees. This is to allow the hips to relax. We really want to relax the muscles. In yin, we're focusing on really relaxing, releasing the muscles so that the work starts to happen within the joint, the fascia, and the connective tissue surrounding the bones. So I'm going to take my right shin in front. And again, it can be really loose. It doesn't really matter what this looks like. Pay attention to how it feels. So right shin or ankle is in front of the left shin. And you're just going to start out by walking your fingertips forward. Any amount. Press down through your fingertips. You can start to rest your chin towards your chest. Keep rooting the sit bone down into whatever it is that you're sitting on. Don't worry so much about how far you fold. Start to pay attention to where the body wants you to stop and pause and breathe there. So it might be that some of us feel like elbows reaching the floor, forearms reaching the floor is accessible, which is fine. If you're getting that close to the floor, you could take a prop or two underneath the forehead to rest the forehead. You can also just release the head to gravity. Notice if you've gone too far, if the body's asking you to back out. One really common signal of that is the breath starts to become short, shallow, or labored. So you can really tune into the breath. Use that as a teacher or a guide. Keep relaxing the back of your neck. Keep relaxing your shoulders. Can you relax the crown of your head? Two more deep breaths here, arms just stretching forward. Now we'll back off of our forward fold a little bit, walking the hands back towards that right shin. And then I'm going to take my hands off to the left side. So more towards my left knee, beyond my left knee, and coming back into that forward fold. And it might be that I'm forward folding a little bit less than I was before, which is fine. Again, you're just taking it slowly, letting your body relax any amount. There's no particular goal. Can you stay rooted through your right sits bone? Notice the tendency for the right sits bone to kind of want to pick up when you're reaching in the opposite direction. Stay rooted through your right sits bone. Breathe into the right low back, the right ribs. Let's take two more deep, slow belly breaths here. Take it super slow on your exit, just walking the hands back towards the body. Start to pull your spine up towards a seat. We'll take our hands behind our hips, just root down behind the hips. Take your knees up towards the ceiling, let your feet be wide. And then you start to sway your knees side to side. You might notice as you do this, the butt starts to scoot forward and you might even come off of your prop. That's fine, it's normal to kind of inch your way forward a little bit. Two more times, right to left. And then we'll set up for the second side. So we'll come back to our seat. If you need to adjust the height of whatever it is you're sitting on, feel free to do that at any time. And this side might feel really different. It might need a different level of support, different kind of propping. We're going to take the left shin or the left ankle in front. Again, let it be loose. Come back to that rooted right and left, nice tall spine, deep breath in here. Deep breath out. Now we'll walk the hands forward. And without any particular goal, just start to let the chin draw in towards the chest. Let your body fold any amount. Deepening into the breath. Maybe you add some support underneath the forehead to rest your head on, or maybe you just let the head relax to gravity. And start to be still. Can you be still here? Notice where you're feeling sensation right now. Notice if you're holding tension anywhere. Maybe it's unconscious. Can you kind of search out those places in the body where you might still be gripping? Just bringing some awareness. Take a full deep breath in. And imagine releasing any extra tension on your exhale. two deep breaths here. Take your time on your exit. Super slow, just walking the hands back towards that left shin as you lift up. And then we'll take it off towards the right side, beyond the right knee. And you stay engaged through that left hip, so the left hip still pressing down into the mat. And you're only forward folding off to this side as far as you can while maintaining contact with the left hip. Relax your shoulders, relax your chin to your chest. Deep breath in, deep breath out. On this side too, you can always take those props with you. If you're resting your forehead on something, you can slide it over and continue to rest. Two more deep breaths in and out. Take your time to back out of this shape. Grow tall through your spine. Let your shoulders relax down your back. Deep breath in. Deep breath out. Bring your hands behind your hips. Take your knees up towards the ceiling. Walk your feet out wide on your mat. And then again, swaying your knees side to side. Just rinsing through the joints of hips, knees, and ankles. Good. All right. So now we will come down onto our backs on our mats. So whatever it is you were sitting on, you would set that off to the side. I wasn't sitting on my cat. She just happened to be behind me. We'll see if I can do this without disturbing her. Not quite. All right. So we're going to lie down on our backs. You could always take a blanket or a really kind of flat pillow underneath the back of your head. I always like to do that, especially if you're on a hard surface, on a hard floor. It's nice to have some padding at the back of the skull. Have your strap or whatever it is that you're going to be using for your strap close by that you can grab. And then stretch the legs out long. Just take a moment here to shrug your shoulders down your back, slightly tilt your chin towards your chest, lying flat on your back. Deep breath in, deep breath out. Let's start the shape by bending both knees and planting the feet hip width distance apart. And then we'll take the ball mount of the right foot into what you're using for your strap. Press that up towards the ceiling. So be sure that you're getting the ball mount of your foot and not the arch of your foot so that you can start to pull those toes towards the face and the heel moves towards the ceiling. You're starting to feel some, maybe some sensation along the back of the right leg. Just pause here for a few moments. So let your elbows relax down towards the ground. Let the back of the head remain heavy and the shoulders rest. Just a little bit of tension to the ball end of the foot into the strap. You can always bend this knee, this right knee, if you like. And then maybe if it feels okay, you stretch that left leg out long. If that's too much on the low back, the hips, or the knee joint, just rebend the left knee and plant the foot. You might give it a try both ways and see which way works best for you. A couple more breaths here. Now we'll take both ends of your strap into your right hand. Extend your left arm out to the side so that you're counterbalancing the weight. We're going to turn the right toes towards the right shoulder and find some external rotation of the right hip. Not looking for a big, huge opening here. We're still just working in a more shallow place with our joints, kind of letting them know something deeper and more longer holds are coming. Just taking it super gentle right now. It might be that your right leg goes all the way down to the floor. It might be that it's kind of floating somewhere in space. I'm kind of lucky here because I have a wall I get to rest my right foot on. It feels kind of nice. You can always set your right elbow down, tricep down, and kind of rest the foot that way. Still have a little bit of tension of the ball end of the foot into the strap. Deep breath in, deep breath out. Let's take two deep belly breaths here. Press the foot into the strap to bring it back up through center. And then we'll take the left hand, wrap those fingers around both ends of the strap. Take your right hand thumb into your right hip crease and press the hip crease away from your ribs. So you're rooting the hip in its socket and you're keeping the right hip rooted on the ground. And you're just barely turning those right toes towards the left shoulder, finding a little bit of internal rotation. Now your left leg, which is stretched out long maybe, or the knee is bent, it's neutrally rotated in the hip socket. You're finding this internal rotation of the right hip in its socket. So for me, I feel this mostly along the outer edge of my right leg, along the calf, the IT band. It really doesn't take much movement. A couple deep breaths here. Next breath in, we're going to start to move the right foot back towards the ceiling. And this time, you can take both of your hands, kind of walk it up the strap towards the foot. Start to bend that right knee. You're coming into like this half-happy baby. So the right knee moves towards the right armpit, the thigh towards the outer waist. See if you can get the foot to stack on top of the knee. Deep breath in. Deep breath out. Two deep belly breaths here. We'll start to release that right foot. We're going to pause in between sides. So you can choose to either extend your right leg long to meet your left leg, flat on your back like you're in Shavasana. You can also bend the knees and plant the feet if your low back feels achy at all. Either way, let's just pause in between sides. Let your eyes close. Trace your line of awareness along the right side of the body. two deep breaths here. All right, so we'll set up our second side, and I'd recommend starting out by bending both of your knees, planting the feet hip-width distance apart. You can loop up the left foot. Send that foot straight up towards the ceiling. If you can get your prop around the ball mound of the foot instead of the arch of the foot. Relax your elbows, your shoulders, relax the back of your head. You're flexing your left toes towards your face and the heel is moving towards the ceiling. You can extend your right leg long if you wish, but notice how that changes the rotation of the hips. If it really feels lopsided, just re-bend your right knee and plant that right foot. If it's too much on the hamstring or anywhere along the body, modify, adjust. Deep breath in, deep breath out. We'll start to take both ends of the strap into the left hand. You can extend your right arm out to the side to counterbalance, keeping your right shoulder grounded. Start to turn the left toes out to the left side. You're finding that external rotation in the hip socket. Does not matter how far that left leg moves towards the floor. That's not the goal or the purpose. The purpose is to start to become aware of the body. Start to become aware of our choices, our actions, and how we react to certain stimulus. Yoga practice is a great laboratory to acknowledge and notice and really learn something about ourselves. Take two deep breaths here. A little bit of tension of the ball mound of the foot into the strap as you pull it back up towards the ceiling. Taking the strap into your right hand, your left thumb nestles its way into the left hip crease. You're really rooting that hip into its socket. It's gonna stay right there, and you're just barely turning the toes towards your right shoulder. You might sweep that left foot across the body a few inches, but it's not in an effort to find a twist. So your left hip staying grounded. Feeling for a little bit of sensation outside of the left leg. Deep breath in. Deep breath out. Two deep, slow belly breaths here. To bring the left foot back towards center, you can start to walk the hands towards the left foot and then bend that left knee wide. So the knee starts to move towards the armpit. See if you can see the ankle stacking on top of the left knee. It's like you're in half happy baby. Deep breath in. Deep breath out. Two more breaths here. press the foot into the strap, re-extend the leg, and then set the strap off to the side. Let your left leg relax completely. Whether your legs are straight or the knees are bent, find a comfortable position to rest here for a few moments. Can you let your eyes close? Draw a line of awareness along the left side of the body. Right. So if your legs are stretched out long, I recommend bending your knees. We'll roll off to a side. We're going to come all the way over onto our belly. We'll set up for Sphinx pose. And there's a few different ways that you can prop your Sphinx. If you want a little extra padding underneath the forearms and the elbows, you can have a blanket there where your head was resting to give a little extra padding to the elbows. If you have a block at home, you can use that underneath the forehead to rest your forehead on. You can also take a bolster or a cushion underneath the armpits to rest the chest on. So we'll come down onto our belly. We'll stretch the feet out behind us, let the tops of the feet rest. So my bolster is pretty thick and tall. It's putting my back into quite a bit of flexion. And you can adjust your intensity of inflection. So if your bolster, your cushion's adding too much of that compression of the low back, you could just get rid of it. And maybe you try more of like a... looks almost more like a Superman shape. So you'd walk your hands more forward beyond the top of your yoga mat. You can rest your forehead here. If you don't have a block, you could also use a couple of pillows or cushions. Kind of just find somewhere in between that's going to allow you to breathe deep into the belly, to relax your glutes, relax your tailbone. Can you soften the shoulders? Soften the jaw. We'll start to add on time here, so we'll take a little bit more time, about 2 minutes in this shape. I'll set my timer. Scanning the body, noticing if you're gripping anywhere, relax your fingertips, relax your elbows, relax the shoulders, feel the throat open and soften. Two deep breaths in and out through the nose here. We'll start to walk our way out of this so the palms can press down underneath the shoulders.
Press your way up to tabletop. And then in between to release, you can move through some cat and cow here. You can arch the spine up and down, or you can send the hips back towards the heels and find child pose. Couple more deep breaths, whatever you're doing, whether you're still or you're moving in and out of shape. All right, so we'll come down again onto our back, same position you just came from before that back bend. And again, for this shape, I recommend do have something underneath the back of your head, like a folded blanket. You don't want too much height because you don't want to be cranking your neck, but you do want to have some padding at the back of your head. I find that's really helpful, and we're gonna take a twist on our back. So oftentimes when we're twisting, the lower half of our body and the shoulder starts to leave the floor. If you add a little bit of elevation under the head, this lets the neck relax and the shoulders stay grounded. So it might be something you try adding on to your practice. I'm going to take my cushion off to the left side of my mat. And then I'm going to lay down so my left hip is closest to my cushion. My head's resting on my blanket. And then I'll find my strap again. Loop up the ball mount of my right foot. You were just here. We're turning this into a deeper twist. So we did a lot of prep work for the body for this. Now I'm going to take the strap, both ends of the strap, into my left hand. Again, reach my right arm out to the side. And this time, as I find that internal rotation, allow your right hip to roll all the way on top of your left. And you have this cushion here waiting for you. So you can relax the inner edge of the right leg along your cushion. And you can always add height to this. So you can continue to stack blocks, pillows, blankets, as much height as you need so that you can stay grounded through your shoulders. Let your back, the back of your head be heavy. You can keep the strap around the ball mount of the foot, just lightly holding it in your left hand. If you like, or you can just let it be soft and relax. You can bend both of your knees. You could keep them straight. Really get to customize this for your body. Maybe you let your eyes close down. Notice where you're feeling the sensation right now. Perhaps it's in multiple places in the body. Let yourself be still so that you can start to notice If you want, you could take your gaze over your right shoulder so that maybe you're kind of looking at, or if your eyes were open, you'd be looking at your right fingertips. I find that that adds a little bit too much tension to my neck and my shoulder, so I prefer to keep my gaze up towards the ceiling, but you check that out in your body and see what works best for you. Keep coming back to your breath. Let it be really full. Just take two more deep breaths in and out through the nose here. If you still have that strap around the foot, you can use that to provide a little bit of tension into the ball mound of the foot to sweep that right foot back up towards the ceiling. Nice and slow. Let both of your hips ground. And release the right foot. Again, pausing in between sides, you can choose whether you want to stretch your legs out or keep your knees bent. A couple of breaths here, just pausing in stillness. So set up for our second side, moving whatever prop you were using for that right leg off to the right side, close to the hip, so that it's going to be supportive of the inner knee, the inner thigh, maybe even the ankle. You can extend your right leg long, let it rest on the mat, loop up the ball mound of your left foot. Take both ends of your strap into your right hand, extend your left arm out to the left side, and find that internal rotation, left toes moving towards the right shoulder. Continue with that trajectory until you're rolling all the way onto your right hip. Your left hip is stacking on top. And you can either keep that leg straight, or you can bend the knee. You can also bend the bottom knee. The one thing that I'd like you to continue to be aware of is the left shoulder grounded? Do you need to add any propping underneath the head or underneath the inner left knee to allow the shoulders to completely relax? Really up to you whether or not you want to keep a hold of the strap or just completely relax into this twist, no tension. Start to close the eyes if you haven't already. Long, deep, slow belly breaths. With each exhalation, imagine releasing any tension, any stress. to you, whether you're turning your gaze over your left shoulder or you're keeping the back of the head resting, neck neutral. Noticing the breath, whatever you're choosing, notice how deep and slow and consistent the breath can be. Take your last couple deep, slow belly breaths here. When you're ready to release, you could press the foot back into the strap to provide a little bit of feedback as you re-extend the left leg towards the ceiling, rolling back onto the left hip. And release that leg. Either stretch your legs out long or bend the knees and plant the feet. Pause. And perhaps here you're already feeling this descension into a Shavasana-like state. Feel free to just continue to head there. But if you need to add any extra props to your Shavasana, like support underneath the backs of the knees, or weight to the belly, or a blanket over the whole length of the body, even something to cover the eyes might be nice. Letting your Shavasana be what you desire. Take your time to set that up for yourself. That might even mean coming to a seated meditation instead of lying flat on your back. So as you arrive into that stillness, as you descend further into Shavasana, take a moment to move the shoulders away from the ears and slightly tilt the chin to the chest. Find the sensation of the weight of the eyes sinking heavy into their sockets. Take a big breath in through your nose. And let your mouth open, exhale the air out. Let your back teeth part. Let your tongue widen at the base of your mouth. Let the tip of the tongue rest at the bottom palate, the base of the teeth. And then draw your awareness with the eyes closed to the space between the eyebrows. And notice if you see any colors or shapes, any images. And at first, it's really normal to just see black, static, like a TV screen that scrambles. And as you continue to focus your awareness and enter into a deeper state of relaxation, colors, shapes, and images will emerge. Now bring your attention and awareness to the sound of my voice. Keeping your eyes closed. Just listening. Awareness to the sound of my voice. Awareness back to you and your body, where you are in space and time. Awareness back to the sound of my voice, where I am in space and time. Awareness back to you, your breath, your body. And the space in between. Awareness back to my voice. I'm coming into a state of listening. In your Shavasana, in these last few moments, I'll share with you a reading from a book called Meditations on the Mat by Rolf Gates and Katrina Kennison. I rarely teach a class that doesn't include at least one student who is brand new to yoga. Working with beginners affords me an excellent opportunity to observe just what it is we bring to our mats, despite wide age, gender, socioeconomic, cultural, and physical differences. We all carry some of the same baggage. Whether you are a dancer, a housewife, a grad student, a retired police officer, or an aerobics dropout, you will no doubt confront the same roadblocks to learning that I see in students encounter every day: pride and fear. If you are new to yoga, chances are you are wrestling not only with the postures, but also with the judgments you pronounce on your efforts. But if you can make a commitment to be a little bit easier on yourself, I am certain you will enjoy your practice more. If not, you may soon find yourself making all sorts of excuses to avoid practicing altogether. It will become just too painful. When we opt out of experiences that challenge us, it's usually because our pride is in the way. And pride is really another word for fear. The fear of not being enough. Marlon Brando delivers this truth magnificently in Apocalypse Now. When sweating in an idea of spiritual bankruptcy, he tells his executioner, "It is our judgment that defeats us." We become our own executioners when we sit in judgment of our efforts. Only when we act without judgment can we truly flourish in our lives. Yoga means becoming one. As long as we stand apart in judgment, we sabotage the opportunity for connection and integration that is yoga. So I encourage you, get into that canoe and ride with the river. Commit and don't look back. Before our bodies can open, they must first let go. The clenched and guarded muscles must relax, but the mind must let go first. Feel free to continue to stay with your shavasana as long as you like. You can ignore this next part if you've come to a place of peace. You're ready to move on with your day. Begin to awaken through fingertips and toes. Moving the head side to side. Your next inhale, big breath in, stretch the arms up and overhead. Pointing the toes away from the face, breathing into the length of your body. Bending your knees, rolling off to a side, find fetal position. Take your time, maybe you keep your eyes closed or a soft gaze as you rise up to a comfortable seat, if you're not already there. Once you find yourself seated, feel your sits bones rooting down, feel your spine growing tall, take a big breath in. Taking a breath out, hands together at your heart, bowing the chin to the chest. Here we offer reverence and gratitude for our practice. To all of our teachers, past, present, future, and to the teacher within your own heart. Namaste.